Right, and we have PDP Chief Mehbooba Mufti with us on the phone line. Ms. Mufti, you know, this ruckus that occurred in the assembly earlier today, was there a point that you were really trying to prove earlier today?
Basically, we had no point to prove today. Actually, it was obituary references today, and there the speaker has to just go for the obituary references. And in case he wants to change the business, then he has to take the permission of the House. But the speaker allowed the BJP to take up their issues. He allowed the National Conference MLA from Handwara to take up his issues. So we said, if you are taking other issues, then we also want to raise the human rights violation issue, especially about Shupaya, which he did not allow. So we went into the well. But unfortunately, instead of talking to us and allowing us to take up our issue, he was asking not only the ward and but also the staff, which he should not do as a speaker. He should not ask the staff of the assembly, please drag this lady out of the house.
Ms. Mufti, whatever be the point, whatever be the issue, this is certainly no way to behave inside the assembly.
No, but does it behove a speaker to use a derogatory language about a lady and tell the staff to drag the lady out, and the chief minister is just sitting and doing nothing? I mean, I just touched the mic in front of the speaker and he got so angry. But he literally got me dragged out of the house. Nobody is talking about that.
Ms. Mufti, but this is certainly no way to conduct business inside the assembly. Are you not apologetic for your behavior?
It is for the speaker to give equal treatment to all the honorable members. We were there to pay tribute to the members who are dead. But look at the speaker, how partial he is. He allowed the BJP to take up the issue. He allowed the National Conference. But what about PDP?
Ms. Mufti, are you apologetic for your behavior? Are you going to apologize to
for
the speaker?
For what? What did I do?
You picked up the mic of the speaker, and it's for everyone to see what you did in the assembly.
I just touched the mic. Because I touched the mic, he got me physically dragged out of the house. He was doing that. He was asking them to drag me out of the house. And the chief minister was looking. The chief minister
should have got up. Ms. Mufti, you're a very tall leader. Ms. Mufti, you're a tall leader. You're the leader of the opposition.
But even if there
was some kind of ruckus in the assembly, don't you think you went to the extreme?
What should a lady do when the speaker is ordering the staff to drag her out? What should we do?
Ms. Mufti, do you actually want the speaker to apologize to you?
It's not about PDP or Speaker or Mehbooba Mufti. It's about people's issue. They have already rejected all our resolutions, which we had discussed in roundtable with the Prime Minister, which are within the Indian Constitution, whether it's revocation of special power, withdrawal of troops, stipend for youth, educated youth, cross-movement over LOC, or self-rule. These are all the issues that we have discussed with the Prime Minister on roundtable, and he did discuss them. He even acknowledged them, but the Speaker had the cheek to arbitrarily reject them.
There are issues, but there are ways to discuss those issues, to debate those issues.
If
you are going to hold a dharna, and when you have about a month, how are you going to try and prove your point?
Tell me, who started it? We were sitting very silently, very patiently, because we knew that it was an obituary reference, so nothing doing today besides that. But it was the speaker who was being partial. He allowed the BJP to take up their issues. He allowed the National Conference. He should not have done it. If he wanted to do, he should have sought the permission of the House to change the business of the House. He did it arbitrarily. When we demanded the same, he did not allow us to do so. What do? We went to the well and then he started shouting, drag them out, drag this lady out. And the Chief Minister was watching. How can we allow it to happen?
But at the end of the day, I think you are somewhere setting a precedent. This is certainly not an example you would like to set for others, and this is certainly
not the way to behave in the assembly. It can't be my way or highway. If they don't allow us to talk, because we are there for the people, we have got more votes here than the National Conference.
So are you saying when the assembly restarts its business, you are going to repeat your actions again?
We haven't done anything. If the speaker behaves in the same manner, definitely we will not allow them to for the house to function. He has to accommodate our resolutions, which are very important to us. He has to allow us to raise the issues of the people, which are very important. If they want to choke us as an opposition, we will not allow
Ms.
them
Mufti,
to do that.
Ms. Mufti, isn't it ironical that you are trying to fight the violence in the valley? That's one of the issues you've been fighting for. Somewhere your actions are very similar. I mean, can't you find a more peaceful way to conduct business in the assembly? Is this any way in which your purpose will be solved?
Well, Maruk, when we got up from the seats, we were very peaceful. But it was the speaker, in the very beginning, he should have allowed us, okay, after the National Conference, MLA spoke, he should have allowed us to speak. Why he did not do that?
Ms.
Mufti, you can't expect...
My straight question to you, Ms. Mufti, if a situation like this arises again in the assembly, will you repeat your action again? Will you do the same thing?
Well, if they don't allow us to debate things which are very important, which are very important for the security, for the honor, dignity and day-to-day affairs of the people here in Jammu and Kashmir, and if they misbehave the way, if he uses the same derogatory, if they want to drag us out, then they should also be prepared to be dragged out of the assembly. They will have to face them that.
So, Ms. Mufti, you absolutely don't believe that you were at all at fault in what you did, and you absolutely justify all the actions that you've taken today.
It was the Speaker who started it. Why should he ask the staff to drag me out when we were raising certain issues? I mean, I touched a mic in front of him, but he got me physically removed from the hall. Even before that, he was telling them to do that. I mean, but he got a taste of his own medicine, not as yet. We did not touch him as yet.
Ms. Mufti, it seems like, at least from the visuals that are coming in, you were the first one to point a finger at the speaker, and that is why, you know, he probably demanded that action of this kind is not justified.
I think you should have the recording what the speaker was saying. The speaker was saying, drag this lady out. Didn't hear that. Otherwise, why should I do like that? I just wanted him to have the taste of his own medicine. If you treat a lady like this, I am the leader of the largest opposition here. Does he have? Should he treat a lady like that?
Ms. Mufti,
the BJP people, they all stood up on their seats and he allowed them to speak.
Ms. That Mufti, my final question and a very straight answer to this. Are you unapologetic about everything that happened in the assembly earlier today?
I think it's the onus lies on the National Conference. They should apologize. The Chief Minister should apologize the way the speaker, the words the speaker used, and he was just watching it.
That's a very convenient thing to do, Ms. Mufti. All you're doing is passing the buck.
That is because they are the ruling party. They have to take care of the house.
So you're the opposition. I mean, if they are the ruling,
impartial.
You're the opposition. I mean, you're equally responsible as a politician, as a tall leader.
I say I am a leader because of the people. If you don't allow me to raise the issue.
So you will not apologize.
Where am I going to be tomorrow?
You will not apologize, Ms. Mufti.
I haven't done anything for which I should apologize. I think rather the speaker should know what he was talking about.